What is your definition of complex systems?
So my one sentence definition is systems that don't yield to compact forms of representation or description. And I should explain that. You know, in the systems that physicists study, you can often write down on one page a few very beautiful, elegant equations, like Newton's laws for the conservation of momentum, or the Maxwell field equations for electromagnetism, and so forth. And you can explain a huge amount of empirical data. But when it comes to the genome, or the brain, or properties of society, or literary history, as far as we know, there are no such beautiful, elegant, compact descriptions. And that, for me, is evidence that we're dealing with a complex system. Now, why is that? So the reason why I think it's difficult to do is because those are systems that encode long histories. One of the characteristics for me of a complex system is it's found a means or a mechanism for extracting from its environment some information in order to use it to behave adaptively, to predict and control, and consequently need to be described using models that have a slightly different flavor to the ones that we've been traditionally familiar with in the mathematical natural sciences. And typically those models will be computational.
So I'm going to ask you the same question I'm asking everybody, which is, what is your definition of a complex system?
Oh no, that's...
That's what everybody says.
In theoretical computer science, we don't say that systems are complex or simple per se. We more typically say that questions are complex if those questions require a lot of computational resources to solve. Mm-hmm. A lot of time, a lot of memory, a lot of communication between people, some limited resource. Mm-hmm. Different questions might have different levels of computational complexity. So, for instance, if what you want to know is what will the system look like t time steps from now, well, you can answer that question with about t time by simulating it forward. But an interesting question might be, well, maybe there is no algorithm that works much faster than that. Maybe there's no way to leapfrog over a lot of the history. Maybe, like a chaotic dynamical system that has no closed form solution, maybe there is no shortcut to doing that laborious step-by-step simulation. So for me, I find it helpful to, rather than saying, is this system simple or complex? I mean, I don't deny that we often have clear ideas about that. But I find it helpful to change the question a little bit to give me a yes or no question you want to answer about this system, or a quantity you want to compute about this system, and then let's talk about how hard it is computationally to answer that question or compute that quantity.
Well, it's a complicated concept. I didn't say complex, just kind of complicated. So this actually ties in with the discussion I'm sure we'll have on information. So I have a rather precise notion of what I mean when I refer to a natural or artificial system as complex. And what I mean in particular is that it has a very sophisticated internal causal architecture that stores and processes information. So the technical things we'll talk about shortly have to do with how we measure stored information and the amount of structure. So information, in many ways, stands in for trying to describe how complex a complex system is, various kinds of information processing and storage can be associated with how a system is organized. So it's a key concept. Certainly, Shannon's original notion of information as degree of surprise, a degree of unpredictability of a system, or how random a system is, needs to be augmented. And so that's certainly a focus of a lot of my work, is trying to delineate that there are many different kinds of information, not just Shannonian information.
So my definition of complex systems is a system that has interactions. It has nonlinear elements in it. I tend to work on high-dimensional systems, not low-dimensional systems. And I like to use the methods of statistical mechanics from physics to understand problems in these systems. Most of the time, the interesting features in these systems have scaling properties, that is to say, they have power laws or fractal objects in them, embedded in them in some place, either in the actual physical arrangement of them or in terms of the statistics that you see.
So my basic definition is a complex system consists of a bunch of entities that may not start out diverse but end up being diverse. They're connected in some way, usually through some sort of network structure or some spatial structure, and they get information and signals through that network or local structure, but they also sometimes get some global signals or global information, which could be prices in a market or temperature, something like that in the system. So in addition to being sort of diverse and interconnected, they're also interdependent. So the actions of one, you know, agent in the system will sort of influence or have implications for another agent. So in the context of a social system like economics, I'll say, if I go out and buy bread at the grocery store, whether I buy whole wheat bread or white bread, you really don't care. It's not interdependent. You know, there's no real strong interdependence other than through the prices. But if I decide to, like, you know, drive my car on the road or drive my car really fast on the road, those sort of things, then that actually can affect you in a big way. So they're interdependent. And then the last thing is, in addition to having sort of these interdependent behaviors and networks and diverse agents, that the agents adapt and respond to the environment which they're in. So it's not just a case of them following simple rules, but that they sort of adapt. Now, this last part gets a little bit tricky philosophically, because adaptation is really just a higher order rule. So you can have a sort of a first level rule and then a meta rule. And so you could say that they're rule based, but they're sort of meta rule based, that they allow for behavior that can respond to the signals they're getting both sort of locally and globally. The last thing I'd mention, this is sort of another sort of paradox in the definition of complex adaptive system, is a system like that can be complex, but it need not be, right? So a system could have all those components to it, but yet it can end up producing an equilibrium. So if I look at, you know, especially economic systems, some parts of economic systems really equilibrate quite well, but then others end up being really complex. So if you look at oil consumption over time at the global level, that's pretty predictable. It's a pretty stable pattern. But if I look at oil prices over time, that's complex because there's much more sort of interdependencies and all those things come into play. So John Holland and I sometimes joke that we maybe should call them systems capable of producing complexity.
That doesn't sound as marketable.
Okay, well, that's a question people have debated a lot, but I guess most people would agree that a complex system is a system of many interacting parts where the system is more than just the sum of its parts. It shows emergent behaviors which are not just the sum of the individual behaviors of the parts. Other people add extra elements to that, but I think that's probably what my definition is, pretty much. It's a system of interacting parts which shows emergent behaviors.
Okay, that's pretty simple. Sort of unpacking that takes a little more time, but...
So I'm going to give you a definition of complex systems, but I will remind you that many important concepts like virtue and life are very hard to define, and I think complex systems are somewhat in that category. But nonetheless, the kinds of systems that I call complex have many interacting active components, and the interactions between the components have non-trivial or non-linear interactions, and that leads to the system having unpredictable behavior. You may have heard that those things before, but importantly, all of the components are either learning or modifying their behavior in some way while the system is behaving, and so that leads to all kinds of interesting dynamics. So that's roughly what I think of when I think of a complex system.
So do you think adaptation is essential for complex behavior?
Well, it's essential for the kind of complex behavior I'm most interested in.
Okay, fair enough.
Well, I think my definition is probably like a lot of other people's definition, in that a complex system is something with a lot of interacting parts, where something about the way those parts behave when they interact is qualitatively different than the way they behave if you look at them individually. So it's something with emergent phenomena. And I think we can then quibble about exactly what all those words really mean. And so I might mean something a little bit different than some other people, but I don't think I have anything particularly unique in my definition.
Complex systems tends to be things that they are different from simpler, usually physical systems, in that they tend to be heterogeneous. They tend to be made up of parts that are not the same kind of parts. For example, people and firms in a city are all different. They're not all the same. They tend to be, many of them are open-ended, though not all of them. So a city or an ecosystem can keep on evolving. And often the thing that makes them hardest to study in terms of making predictions about them is that they also typically have chains of causation, mechanisms that make things happen. There are circular, so there are feedbacks, both positive and negative, that make their evolution at least more difficult to study than in simpler physical systems or engineered systems, where we can deal with them in regimes where they're simple, they're linear, and they respond in ways that we can at least hope to characterize. So those things sort of are still an operating definition of what a complex system might be, but they go a long way to say what a complex system typically is, from ecosystems to organisms to cities to brains.
You know, a complex system is one that contains, you know, enormous numbers of actors or agents that are interacting, usually in a nonlinear kind of fashion, from which all kinds of multi-level behavior evolves from. So there are these emergent phenomena. But also, I think a critical part of a complex system that distinguishes it from what we might call a simple system, like the motion of the planets around the sun, is that on the one hand, you can't encapsulate the dynamics in just a few simple equations, and that is intimately related to the fact that these systems are evolving and are adaptable. And I think this is one of the most crucial differences between that and traditional systems that I've dealt with in most of my career under the guise of physics.